In this video, I'm going to show you how to quickly calculate simple moving average for a data. Hey there everyone, welcome to Technisha, where you can find tips and tutorials on productivity tools. If you are new here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and smash the bell icon to stay updated. A moving average can smooth out the noise from random outliers and emphasize on the long-term trends of a data. This can be really useful for data analysis. Let's see how we can do this in Microsoft Excel. Here is the data of vaccine doses administered in a country for a period of 2 months. Let's try and chart this data. So I've selected the complete data set and then I go to the Insert menu and pick this chart. Here, we can see the data of the doses administered per day, but there are a lot of ups and downs, and it's difficult to make out a clear trend. Let's try and calculate a moving average for this data. Since this is a time series interpretation where there are both weekdays and weekends, it may be beneficial for us to do a 7-day moving average. So let's go to column D to calculate a 7-day moving average. Let me just name it. To calculate the 7-day simple moving average for a date, we need to average the data of the past 7 days. So we can start on this data set only from the 8th. So on this cell, we need to average the previous 7 days data for the doses administered. So let's go to cell D11 and type in the formula equal to average of, let's pick from cell 4 to cell 10, which is 7 dates, and just press enter. Now, this is the data which is calculating the average for the previous 7 days. If we just double click here at the bottom right corner, we are going to fill the formula for the complete data set. So now, if you select for the 9th, the dates are going to be from 2nd to 8th. Similarly, for 10th, the data is going to be from 3rd to 9th. So on and so forth. Now let's try and chart the 7-day moving average along with our doses administered. Let me just delete this chart. Now let's select the data again. Remember, I can select the data quickly by putting Ctrl Shift and the right arrow and the bottom arrow. And let's go to Insert, pick a chart, and let me pick this chart now. Let's put this down. Let me just thicken the line here, so that we can see it more clearly. So I right click out here and click on Format Data Series and just go to the color column here, and in the width, let's put it as 5 points. There, we can now clearly see the 7-day moving average, and it is relatively easier to make out what the long-term trend is. Let's say that now we wanted to make it a 3-day moving average. All we need to do is to go to the 4th day here and type in the formula equal to average of the previous 3 days data and press enter. And just copy this formula all the way down. Now you can look at the 3-day moving average. Depends on your needs, a moving average can be really useful for data analysis. I hope that this tutorial was of use to you. If you liked it, please subscribe to my channel. Till next time, ciao.